Welcome to English online classes. Dear students, we have already discussed how to write the direct speech into indirect speech or reported speech, and we have also studied by sentence wise, right? First we learned how to write the indirect speech of assertive sentences. Next we learned how to write the interrogative sentences into reported speech, then imperative sentences, and then lastly exclamatory sentences. Dear students, let us write all the sentences in a reported speech one by one. So here are some of the examples randomly I have taken, and one by one let us try to write it in a reported speech. Before you watch the video, just note down the questions and try to find the answers, and after that you can check your answers so that if you have any doubts you can make it clarify. I have already given you 3-4 tables, and by referring those tables it will be easy to write the reported speech. Okay, just refer the table and try to answer these questions. Fine dear students, let me answer it one by one. The first question is, Aniket said, "Can I go out to play?" Dear student, what kind of a sentence is this, or what kind of a what kind of a sentence is this? Of course it is a interrogative sentence, right? And in interrogative sentence, in the sense questions, what type of a question is this? Can I go out to play? What response do you get? Yes, you will get yes or no response, right? So it is a yes or no question, and since it is question, which reported verb we have to use? Yes, we have to use questioned or asked. And since it is yes or no question, what linker we have to use? We have to use either if or whether as the linker. Fine, then whatever changes we have to do, we have to change the tense, we have to change the pronouns too. Okay, fine. How to write the answer to this in the reported speech? Aniket asked. Here no need to write the indirect object. Okay, here no need to write an indirect object because it is not referred there, and since it is said is used, no need to write. If it is given only, then you have to write that Aniket asked so and so. So Aniket asked if what it should be, the word order must be changed, right? So I becomes what? He. Aniket asked, can I go out to play? Here I refers to whom? Aniket. So while writing here, we have to write he. Aniket asked if he can becomes could. If I could, sorry, if he could go out to play. Go out to play. So this is the reported speech of this question. Aniket said, "Can I go out to play?" Aniket asked if he could go out to play. Okay. Look at the next sentence. The mother said to her son, "Where have you left the keys? Where have you left the keys?" What kind of a question is this, dear students? Yes, it is a WH question, right? You will get answers in the form of a sentence or in the form of words. Fine. What reporting verb can we use? We can use asked itself. The mother asked. Since it is indirect object is given, we have to write a indirect object. The mother asked her son. WH word, what we have to use? Linker. WH word, question word itself, right? So WH question word itself we have to use. So the mother asked her son, where he have you becomes a he had. where he had left the keys. Where he had left the keys. The mother asked her son where he had left the keys. So here also the word order is changed. The question became the statement. Okay, next one. The captain said about you, he is certainly one of our best players. So we are reporting to whom? To this person itself. Okay, to whom it is said about? To that person itself we are saying. So how to write? The captain said about you. We can write told about you, or the captain declared about you. Declared about you. Here we have to use that. Why? Because he is certainly one of our best players. This is a statement, isn't it? This is a statement. So we have to use that here. The captain declared about you that. About you that. He refers to whom? This you, right? So what we have to write? He refers to you. You only we have to write there. The captain said about you, he is certainly. Here the captain said about whom? This person. Okay. And the captain declared about you that you, since it is what we have to use. For you we cannot use was. You was we are not supposed to use, but we can use you were, right? While speaking also I'll be saying you was, no, you were or you are we are saying, right? So like that here you were one of our becomes what? One of their best players. Best players. The captain declared about you that you were one of their best players. So this is the reported speech of the above sentence. Okay, next look at the fourth question or the fourth sentence. I said to them, let us go out for a walk. I said to them, let us go out for a walk. What kind of a sentence is this? It's a suggestion, isn't it? Let us go. So how can we write? I suggested them. I suggested them. So for the imperatives, for suggestions, then commands, orders, requests, what we have to use for imperative sentence? This comes under imperative sentences. For imperative sentences we have to use to infinitive, right? So I suggested them to go out for a walk. I suggested them to go out for a walk. Okay, so this is the reported speech of this above sentence. Okay, let us look at the fifth question. Mr. David said, is Mr. Smith at home? So what kind of a question, a sentence is this? It's of course interrogative sentence, and it is a yes or no question. So how to write? Mr. David asked if Mr. Smith was at home. David asked if Mr. Smith was at home. Okay, sixth question. Shall we send it to your flat, sir? He said to the customer. Shall we send it to your flat, sir? He said to the customer. So how to write? He said to the customer that, sorry, he asked, I'm sorry, he asked, he asked the customer, shall we send it to your flat, sir? What kind of a question is this? Yes or no questions, right? So he asked the customer either whether or if we can use whether they should. Whether they should send, it becomes what? That to your becomes his flat. He asked the customer whether they should send that to his flat. Here we have changed the pronouns. Then tense also we have changed, shall become should here, okay, and we have used the question reporting verb. Okay, next, seventh sentence. He said to me, would you like to have a drink? He said to me, would you like to have a drink? How can we write? He asked me, if I, would like to have, a drink. He asked me if I would like to have a drink. Okay. Next question, the eighth question. The man said, I have completed my work for the day. The man said that, he had, completed his work for the day. He had completed his work for the day. Okay, let us see some more examples. Next example is, the worker said, we are repairing the road. The worker said, we are repairing the road. How to write it in a reported speech? The worker, the workers said that they were repairing, the road. The workers said that they were repairing the road. So we became they, are became were, right? The tense is changed. Okay, look at the next question. The workers said, we were repairing the road. The workers said that, it's in a which tense? Past continuous tense. Which tense we have to write? Past perfect continuous tense we have to write. So how to write? The workers said that they had been repairing the road. They had been repairing the road. The workers said that they had been repairing the road. Why? Because it is a past continuous tense. So we have written in a past perfect continuous tense. Next one, the teacher said, I shall tell you a story. The teacher said that she she would tell them a story. The teacher said that she would tell them a story. Next, 12. A little boy said, I will buy that toy aeroplane. A little boy said that he would buy that toy aeroplane. A little boy said that he would buy that toy aeroplane. Next, she said, I get up at 5 a.m. every day. So it is a habitual action. Here, dear students, please remember, for habitual action, for universal truth, and for historical truths, we are not changing the tense. Okay, we are not changing the tense in the reported speech. Why? Because they cannot be changed. Those universal truth, habitual action, and historical truth, that cannot be changed. So we are writing in the same tense which is given in the direct speech. So she said that she gets up at 5 a.m. every day. She said that she gets up at 5 a.m. every day. Not she got up at 5 a.m. every day. We are writing as she gets up at 5 a.m. every day. She said that she gets up at 5 a.m. every day. If we write here got up, then what happens? That there is no meaning to the sentence. It becomes nonsense sentence. That's why, look at here, for habitual actions, universal truths, and historical events, we are not changing the tense. Okay, look at here. He said, change is the law of nature. This is the universal truth, right? For this also, we are not going to change the tense. He said that change is the law of nature. He said that change is the law of nature. So, for historical truths, for habitual actions, for universal truth, we are not changing the tense while writing the reported speech. We are writing the same tense of the direct speech in the indirect speech. Next, last one, he says, I don't eat fruits. Okay, I don't eat fruits. And look at here, he says, in the direct speech, this reporting verb is in the present tense, isn't it? Everywhere it is in the past tense, but here in the direct speech itself, it is in the present tense. What is that? This reporting verb is in the present tense. If the reporting verb is in the present tense, whatever question it may be, the tense is not changing. We are not supposed to change the tense. Okay, whatever sentence it may be, we are not changing the tense. When there is a reporting verb in the direct speech which is in the present tense. Okay, so he says that he does not eat fruits. He says that he doesn't eat fruits. Okay, this is very important. These three questions you have to be careful while writing the answers. Why? Because this is a habitual action, this is universal truth, and here the reporting verb is in the direct speech is in the present tense. Okay, so direct speech is in the present tense, so you have to write the same tense which is given here. So since it is he, it became a does here. Okay, he says that he doesn't eat fruits. Dear students, these are some of the examples for reported speech. Here I conclude, or here I end the discussion of the grammar topic, that is reported speech. Dear students, in 10th standard you have the question which is for 2 marks, and you will get one sentence, so that you have to change it into reported speech. And for second PUC students, the question is for 5 marks, you will get a piece of conversation, and you have to report it in a you have to report that piece of conversation. Okay, and while writing that report, you have to write that in a paragraph, not sentence wise. You have to make a whole paragraph, and you have to answer that. Okay, so this is about reported speech. So for it is better to practice and learn. If you have any doubts, you can contact me at any time and clarify your doubts. Thank you for watching.
Hello students, welcome to English online classes. Dear students, in today's class let us learn the grammar, and in grammar let us learn the particular topic, that is active voice and passive voice. Dear students, what do you mean by active voice and passive voice? In active voice and passive voice, we are saying the same sentence in 2 ways. Okay, the subject order is changed and the meaning is same. We are writing the 2 different sentences. We are writing the same sentence in 2 different ways, but without changing the meaning. Okay, we are writing the same sentence in 2 ways, but without changing the meaning of the sentence. Dear students, here we are writing the order of the sentence, or the word order of the sentence, in a reverse order. Look at the sentence here on the board. Rakesh kicked the ball. It is in active voice. The ball was kicked by Rakesh. It is in passive voice. Dear students, let us learn the difference between active voice and passive voice. The first sentence, Rakesh kicked the ball. Here, who did the work, or who did the action? Rakesh did the action, right? What did he do? He kicked. What did he kick? He kicked the ball. So here, Rakesh is the doer, and his action is kicking. And what did he kick? The effect is on whom? The ball, right? So here Rakesh is the subject, kicking is his action, and the ball is the object. Here Rakesh is the agent, he is the doer. And what's the action here? Kicking. And the ball is the receiver of the action. The action was done by whom? Rakesh, right? And the ball is the receiver of that action. And here he is an also the object, or the work was done on the ball. So that is active voice. And in the active voice sentence, we are giving importance to the agent. Okay, we are giving importance to whom? The agent, or the doer of the work, or doer of the action. One who does the action, we are giving importance to him. Okay, to the subject or to the agent, that is in the active voice. Then what, to whom are we giving importance in the passive voice? Look at this sentence. The ball was kicked by Rakesh. Here the importance is given to whom the action was happened. or the importance is given to the receiver, to the object. Okay, the importance is given to whom? To the receiver or to the object. So that is called the passive voice. Dear students, the same exercise we are calling in Kannada as Kartra Prayoga and the Karmani Prayoga. Kartra in the sense the doer, one who does the work. Karma in the sense what? The work or the action, right? So in the active voice we are giving importance to the doer, and in passive voice we are giving importance to whom? The action was done, to the receiver. Okay, to the receiver. And when writing, we are writing without changing the meaning. Okay, without changing the meaning. Only we are changing is that the word order we are changing. We are not changing the meaning of the sentence. Look at here. Rakesh kicked the ball. The ball was kicked by Rakesh. And by writing passive voice, what did we do? What are the changes we did from the active voice to passive voice? In the first sentence, what is Rakesh? What is kicked and what is the ball? Here Rakesh is subject. Kicked is verb and the ball is the object, right? And the same sentence we wrote in passive voice by changing its order. So in the place of subject, we wrote the object of the active voice. In the place of verb, we wrote the verb itself, but adding was this helping verb. Okay, this helping verb. Why are we using this helping verb? Because to show that this is important. Okay, and here kicked is used, and then we used by here as an agent. Okay, so Rakesh is the subject of the active voice, became object in the passive voice. Okay, so there the word order, it was reversed. So the subject of the active voice became the object of the passive voice, and the object of the active voice became the subject of the passive voice. Okay, so passive voice is active voice and passive voice. So here in active voice, agent is given the importance, and in passive voice, the receiver is given the importance. Okay, and the structure of the same sentence, the structure of the same sentence is this: active voice plus subject plus verb. In active voice, subject plus verb plus object, and in passive voice, object plus verb plus subject. So how the order is changed, that is written here. Okay, now look at here. In passive voice, helping verbs, be forms, they are is, are, was, were, and past participle of the main verbs are used. Okay, when writing the passive voice, we are using the past participle of the verb. Past participle. What is the past participle form of the verb? For example, work is the present tense. Work is the present tense. Then worked is the past tense. And past participle form is also work. For example, write, wrote, written. Written is the past participle form of the verb. Of the verb write. Okay. So this form we have to use in the passive voice. Every time, remember dear students, while writing the passive voice, we are using the third form of the verb, that is the past participle form of the verb. What are we using? Past participle form of the verb. And here, look at these sentences. He buys a camera. He buys a camera. So what is the subject here? He. Buys is the verb, right? A camera is the object. Which type sentence? It's an active voice. Right? This is an active voice. How to write it in passive voice? As I said, here the importance is given on the subject. We have to give importance to Walter, the receiver, in the passive voice. Okay, the receiver in the sense the action or the performance or the effect on whom it happens, it is called as the receiver or a object. So here, camera is the object in this sentence, right? While writing the passive voice, what we have to do? We have to write the subject of the active voice in the place of object of the passive voice. So what is the subject of the passive voice then? The object of the active voice. What is the object of the active voice? Object of the active voice is this, a camera, right? So a camera becomes the subject in a passive voice, right? So a camera. Then he buys a camera. To write the passive voice, we need helping verb and what? We need the past participle form of the verb, right? So from where can we get this helping verb and the past participle form of the verb? By looking at this verb, we have to write the helping verb and the past participle of the verb. So, if the sentence is in present tense, if the sentence is in present tense, based on the tense, we are using this helping verb and the past participle form of the verb. Okay, so we have to see the tense here. We are not going to change the tense, but to use this helping verb, we have to see the tense. Remember, to use this helping verb, we have to see the tense. Dear students, in which tense is this? He buys a camera. It is in present tense, right? So we have to write the present tense of the be form. The present tense of a be form. What it suits here? A camera is bought. Okay? So the past, the be form is used here is. Okay? Is. The be form is is. So it is in present tense. And it is singular. So is suitable here. A camera is buy. It's the past participle form is for the bought, right? So a camera is bought by him. By we are using to indicate this agent. Okay, by whom the action was done. Okay, look at the second example. He made a cake. He is the subject. Made is the verb. A cake is the object. Now what we have to do? We have to write the object of the active voice in the first as the subject of the passive voice, right? So what is the object here? A cake. So it becomes the subject of a passive voice, right? Okay, now the sentence is in which tense? To write this helping verb, we need a tense, right? In which tense is that? Yes, of course, it is in a past tense. So, he made. So, by this we can make out which tense is that. And here, since a cake is singular, we are writing the past form of a be form. Okay, the past form of the be form, that is what the was. That is a was. A cake was made by him. He becomes him here. The pronoun, it changes according to the situation. A cake was made by him. We cannot say a cake was made by he, right? So we have to change this pronoun according to the situation. So this is the way of writing the active. made. The students, it is in the present perfect tense, right? He has made. It is in present perfect tense. While writing in the passive voice, how to write? What's the object here? Yes, a speech is the object, right? That becomes the subject of the passive voice. So, a speech has, he has made a speech. A speech has been made by him. Here, he has made a speech. A speech has been. Here, since it is in a present perfect tense, have for has, have and had, what are we using? We are using been. Okay, we are using been. So, a speech has been, and this is the third past participle form of the verb we are using. So, he has made a speech. The active voice, while writing in passive voice, how to write? A speech has been made by him. So the object of the active voice is used as the subject of the passive voice, and the subject of the active voice is used as the object of the passive voice. And he became a him here. So this is the way of writing active voice into passive voice. And in the next session, let us discuss according to the tenses. Okay, in each tenses we are going to change some of the helping verbs here. So let us make us clarify how to write the passive voice in the different tenses.